Starting off with Eve Maxi, leading off Tribe Gaming. And Eve Maxi really wants to start off strong. And this is one of his best kind of performance spots where he loves to be at. So he's coming in with the Queen Charge Dragons. Okay, this is an attack they really utilize in the qualifiers a lot, using that jump spell to give him access towards potentially the back part of the base. So he loves to charge into the Eagle and then give the jump spell in towards a scatter shot, in towards a multi, and then using a Dragons and maybe a Battle Blimp if he wants to switch to it for the Town Hall.
Yeah, and those, I believe we see a lot of delayed kinks coming in from them as well as part of their strategy. Just a slightly different approach that has made this work so well for them. Now, we do have the loons coming in, but this queen needs to funnel her way along. She does. He's going to have her take down the eagle. And we just want to see if we can pick up some traps along the way with those Coco loons.
Yeah, those balloons are going to be able to test for those seeking air mines as the queen continues her charge in. Get ready for a headhunter maybe to use for this king. Yep. There it is deployed. Is it just in time? We're using the rage and able to help slow down that king. Okay, no problem here. His king is going to step into the multi-dark inferno. We got ground skeletons that pop. Needs to take this down. There's the king ability. Let's keep our eye, and he's forced to use that freeze spell. There's a giant bomb continuing this push in, and there is the jump spell. Here we go. The dragons are down. Move his way across from the opposite side of the town hall here.
This is looking beautiful with the pathing so
Queen!
Far. Oh, has to force that ability.
Warden ability!
Oh, and the Warden too early here as
Accidental.
Well.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, let's see how he's going to do this. Is he going to switch this up and not use the blimp across the base because it's an early Warden Eternal Tome? This Queen ability has already been used, so Lady B, the question is going to be, what is he going to do to try to help make his way all the way to this Town Hall?
Yeah, he's got to clear the path now. He's got to be patient.
The Queen's... Oh, no.
Yeah, this has gone a bit belly up for Maxi. JX Tiger looking to flex with a potential defense. We do have the blimp, and look, he does wait for those dragons to cut across, clear the pathing, work collectively together, because this, of course, is to save the two-star.
Yeah.
Royal Champ coming through. We do have the Ice Golem that takes the jump, takes the lead, so she can reserve her ability just a tad bit longer, but can she do it? That Golem taking the fire from the Expo.
Yeah, that Golem's providing a little bit of distraction. The Royal Champion trying to move around. The Grand Warden is still up. We've got the air defense over in the far left, which will pick off the Warden. The RC's ability goes off, doesn't hit that Archer Tower on the bottom side, does damage the Wizard Tower maybe just a bit, but this is, doesn't look like the highest percentage. This Warden is going to get picked off by this air defense eventually once he steps in range. The RC does go down, but that was an accidental Warden ability. Very early there.
Yeah, this is interesting to see. You know, Tribe had such a clean run yesterday, of course, bringing in that perfect war. And this is going to be a lower percentage. We are in the 80% range, but knowing what these teams have been pulling in, especially since JX Tiger has two hitters at 100% hit rate, this could be a huge blow for Tribe Gaming.
Yeah, absolutely. And we talked about it just before that first attack. The defenses for JX Tiger has been strong. They have been coming in and really stopping their opponents in their tracks. And unfortunately, Eve Maxi, it was a matter of the accidental Warden ability there, which really cost him to get that value with the dragons. You saw the frustration on his face, but let's see if Tribe can hope to get a defense from JX Tiger, because a three-star is going to be really hard to make a comeback if you're down by those stars.
It is, but you know, Maxi shows his pro level skills where something so detrimental goes wrong that he is able to save it, bring in the two-star and not get it in the 60% mark where many players would wind up doing.
Yeah, with now Vic coming in first for JX Tiger, and he loves to come in first or second. He typically comes in those positions. He's actually, in the latest, kind of over the last couple months, he's not actually attacked fourth or fifth zero times, which is really interesting to know. So he is a lead-off attacker for JX Tiger. He knows what he wants to do, and he's coming in with, looks like the Hydra a little bit, using a clone spell. So what I want to look at was that sweeper. So we're both of the sweepers pointing away from the Town Hall. We might tend to see tornado traps. I think Tribe Gaming really loves to put tornado traps around the Town Hall to try to stop attacks just like this.
Yeah, and we're going to see if that is going to work in their favor. Maxi would want to see a defense now coming in after his two-star to help keep Tribe in this from the get-go. But we do have the super minions coming out of the CC. Easy for the drags to contend with, especially with the poison down and in place. But over to the left side of the base.
Oh, there it is. The tornado pulls the balloons. But the Dragon Rider should be able to secure it. Wait, they go over. And wait, one final shot. Yes, the town hall goes down.
Yeah, so nice and secure now. We have the queen who's still working along the outside edge of the base. Good help left over here, and the king who supported. This is what you really need with these style attacks, is to have your heroes for the back end, because the dragons start dwindling down here quite a bit, and they need just a little extra support.
Yeah, with the RC still has their ability, there is the ground skeleton, which is going to provide the distraction as the Dragon Riders come through and help take down these final defenses with just over a minute left in this raid. Beautiful attack coming in from Vic of JX Tiger, taking down Eve Maxi's base. And they are indeed starting off with that three-star. So Tribe started off with an 81%. So that is going to be a very low percentage for their first attack. And they're going to have to make a big comeback here.
They are. Now, Tribe Gaming is a team that I can't say that they're known specifically for their defenses, but we have seen them come in with some incredible defenses. And of course, yesterday's match against ATN, which nobody expected to see ATN get knocked out right from the start there. So they just need to bring a little bit more of that magic along today.
Yeah, they will indeed have to kind of figure something out, because if they don't come in with another three-star here, it is almost, the hope could be lost. So the pressure is going to be on the next attacker for Tribe Gaming. Will it be EveCheck? We saw Eve Maxi and EveCheck coming in with the very first attacks, like first and second, and then we saw Kronos, Exorcist, and Nebrax attack later in the war. Remember, that the first set of attackers is what sets the tone, and that's the momentum leading your way through. But Eve Maxi, he's going to help now scout, or potentially he's going to be really helping provide the scouting or viewing potential traps, making sure you drop your blimp, and just have to stay focused. And Kronos, one of the best attackers for Tribe Gaming, he's coming in next, and he needs to get a three-star. So he's a fantastic player to bring that momentum back. Let's see if he does it just here.
Yeah, so coming in with a Queen Charge Drag Rider. Now I notice we do have the Skelly spell. This is something that helps for a lot of distraction, often with the heroes when you want to get a little bit more power. But we can also use it for defending AQs and heroes when you're not going to really be able to get to them right away. Opens up that pathing to the Town Hall. Queen working her way through, and we already have the funnel set with that minion from the northern side of the base and the wizard drop down as well.
Yeah, that's going to be able to help clear that workshop there as the Queen is going to charge her way into the Town Hall. But remember, I think these healers are going to be in range of this Town Hall as she does activate. There is a sneaky goblin that got taken out from the Giant Bomb. Wait, Queen, what are you going for? Oh, you're going for the Skelly, so he's going to have to force to use another spell to protect these healers.
Yeah, already with the invisibility spell, and now with that freeze. But you need to, Carbon. You need to secure that Town Hall and keep the charge moving forward when you're investing this kind of troop space.
Oh, that Queen is stepping into the Town Hall poison. We got Headhunters. We got Super Minions. There's the freeze. Queen's taking a massive amount of damage, rages her up. Can he keep that Queen ability? No, forces it there as they step into the poison spell, but use so many spells in the early part of this raid.
Yeah, this is a bit problematic because typically with these style attacks, you want your Queen ability as you push your way through into the core, especially when you have these surrounding defenses, the long-range expos. We've got the scatter shots that would come in at her, but gets the Drag Riders going, gets a Stone Slayer coming in to tank for the scatter shot. This has nice pathing, just needs that multi down in the core.
Hang on, that Queen is still tanking. So she's protecting the Royal Champion. The Warden ability goes off, so this RC can continue her path through this base. Those Dragon Riders, the Stone Slayer, everything protected. That King takes out the Eagle Artillery, so he's continuing this path through his RC. It's going to help take down the enemy RC.
And we have the Stone Slammer cutting through the core. It is still alive and tanking,
and it's
not even yet opened up the additional CC troops, but here we go, right over the scatter shot.
The Royal Champion helping assist, taking out the multi, taking out these tassels. We got this air defense at the backside. The Warden is about just almost full health. The Owl is helping. We got a bunch of skellies. The King is still up. 30 seconds left. up to the raid, and we got ourselves a three-star answer from Kronos. What an attack to answer. They needed this one to stay in the war.
They definitely did, and now they are looking for the defense to follow. But this is a small victory for them to just get the motivation going and coming in for the team.
Absolutely. To see that his queen was in trouble, he was able still to push through that town hall, even though he had to use that additional freeze spell. And that queen had almost no health. She was almost taken out there from the Grand Warden, the clan castle, but he was able to stay focused and pulled in the three-star with the queen charge dragon riders. We've seen this attack be used so much through the previous qualifiers and now still being used part of the meta in the world final, showing how strong this attack still is if you know what you're doing with it.
Yeah, and Tribe really does know what they are doing with this attack, as they've shown time and time again. But I wonder if some of the teams will start looking at that and getting their numbers, especially with JX Tiger being exceptional base builders.
Yeah, that's the question. Will JX Tiger put another three-star on the board? Well, Tribe is hoping for the defense. We had an 81% two-star from Eve Maxi in his very first attack, meaning that Ren must at least get above an 81. And if he does, they'll keep the lead, have the advantage. But if he three-stars, that is going to be fantastic for JX Tiger. So he's looking to do exactly that. Does decide to bring a heal spell in with the mix for his balloons as he passes his way probably into the middle multi-target inferno, where he expects there to be a bunch of red air bombs.
Yeah, and we often see that is the case. But first, we need to set up the pathing here. As the king's providing the tank, not only for the queen, we sneak in the royal champion to go directly for that scatter shot. A little bit hung up here because we do have the skellies, but Lassie comes in for her aid to help work along. But now she's in the outskirt edge of the base. We need the king to force in for the scatter.
Yeah, this king does not go to the scatter shot, but the Lava Hound is going to target over to this royal champion. So he makes her invisible, so the Lava Hound does not stop her from taking that scatter down. So she's going to be able to use her ability, and her shield will skip across from the builder, from the bomb tower to the archer tower and take out an additional archer tower. So that's going to be some great value from her over on the left. But she doesn't pop the Hound, so that's really nice. Now starting this Lalo over from the right.
Yeah, so we actually get to see the Stone Slimer coming in, and the position here is to force it on that inline edge where we expect to see the traps coming out. This is a damage zone. This is where we expect to see all of the mines and the red air bombs.
Oh, there it is.
Ooh, comes
Mayo
in.
Trap.
It opens up, and he has the heal again, Carbon,
yes,
that he wants to save coming into the multi.
That Eagle Artillery locked onto the huge group of loons, but it just dodges. He heals them up right to the bottom side as they path their way around. The Eagle Artillery is going to go down. He's got a poison spell once this Hound does pop. As he makes his way through, the Scattershot will go down to just these few balloons that he sent as a bag end here. But his Hound should pop for Lava Pups. These balloons are going down fast, but should he have enough? How many traps are going to be located here? Oh, there's one. There's two. Oh. There's more traps.
Oh.
Oh!
And this is exactly why we see these moated sections like this.
What?
No Tesla to force them in. Keeps the loons from getting in there. This is a defense that Tribe was hoping to see. It's not the percentage that they would like, but it is a defense.
It is indeed. So that means they are going to be tied on stars, but JX Tiger will have the advantage due to the percentage. Since Eve Maxi's attack was only an 81%, they're going to be down by quite a bit. So now what Tribe is hoping for is to get a three-star and then hope for another defense, even if it's a 99% two-star. That is what they're praying for.
Absolutely. Now, we do have just a little bit more cleanup value here. Qianren knowing that this could be the difference maker, which is exactly what we saw for the Tang in the last war, just keeping that percent nice and high, but they would still need to carry on with a solid, clean performance.
95% is still in great attack, but it's not a three-star, which means the door is coming back and opening up for Tribe Gaming. This is the upper bracket, meaning if you lose this match, you still have a chance to try to make a comeback in the lower bracket. So it's not all out. It's not over, But if you get pushed down to the low bracket, it's going to be incredibly difficult to push through all those opponents down there. But with that, Sui Lalo, it was the multi-target Inferno with those traps in the middle that stopped it. It's about putting red air bombs near multi-target Infernos where there is no air defense, because you don't want the Hound to pop and then the Lava Pups to activate those traps.
And equally, it was good not to have a Tesla there, because that would have actually drawn the loons right there towards the multi. The fact that he was able to keep the loons out of the mix is really what helped. Now, Nebrax needs to try and continue strong for Tribe Gaming if they want to stay in this one. The defenses need to come through as well, but it always starts with these three stars. And I noticed this time, I see a Valkyrie in the mix.
We do.
Not taking any chances.
We got a Tesla farm that popped immediately over in the left. You know, that Tesla farm was probably to really trip up. Oh, wait. Oh, where did it land? Is it on the outside?
Yes.
It's on the outside of the wall, though. Oh, no. Nebrax, he wanted to be on the other side to take out the queen and the scatter shot. And let's see what he's going to be able to do with the death. At least the queen did go down there.
Yeah, the queen going down is huge, but we wanted that scatter shot here as well. So we don't have the full pathing of the funnel that we wanted to see. He is going to have to sacrifice something else into the mix here to get the job done. Now, bringing in the queen from the northern side of the base, we have the king here as well. And let's see if we bring in that valve to help for the assist, but of course needed if there are any skelly traps along the way. But this is gonna get held off and slowed down with the ice golems.
It will indeed. The poison spell's down. The queen just got stalled up by the one ice golem. King's ability goes off, but that multi-target inferno is gonna be slowly picking off at these barbarians. Is the Yak dead? Yeah, so that means that the Yak won't be able to help assist this king through the wall, but the queen should be able to step her way to the town hall. There's a rage spell being used for his royal champion.
I think that's smart. Extending her life and power, getting her through, drops the invisibility spell. She's got the defending RC on her, though. She will get the multi down, but she will not make her way to the scatter shot, though the king wraps his way around.
Just scatter, scatter.
He's going
RC.
For it.
One more shot. One more. Oh, no. It's one tick of health. It's the Builder Hut that started to repair it. So it's going to be doing damage, and we do even have the enemy RC still alive there.
Two scatter shots on the board now really hurt this one. Carbon freezes up the scatter and the royal champion. Great timing, but he's only got one freeze left. That means he can't use it for the back end.
Yeah, we got the scatter shot over on the far left. We got the scatter shot next to the royal champion. That's going to be way too much. Uses the freeze spell onto it and the RC, but his balloons are gone. This is going to be another two-star for Tribe Gaming. Not only a two-star, but a low percent two-star in this war. And JX Tiger is loving this defense. Their defense is the storyline of this war here.
Yeah, this is really carrying them through right now. And it's very interesting, because looking at this match, you know, you have JX Tigers known for their defense and Tribe Gaming known for their offense, with a perfect war from yesterday's match, which I think is what put them in everyone's favor and sight line, because they were able to take over alternate attacks. But JX Tiger has really brought the right bases to the game today.
Indeed. It was that blimp that did not take out the scatter shot. Granted, I mean, really, even if the scatter shot went down, it didn't seem like he had the push for the Lalo through that Eagle artillery. So now, what is Tribe Gaming going to do? They're going to just have to hope their defenses hold strong for the rest of this war to really have a chance against JX Tiger.
Yeah, and the defenses I do still expect to see coming into the mix. They've already been able to hold off, not the percentage that they wanted to see, but they just need to get a nice solid one in there, and then that could turn the tables easily. I mean, they are making sure that they're bringing the best bases that they possibly can to the mix, which is why we are seeing so many close attacks. Even if they're recovered, you are seeing where they're getting tripped up here.
Yeah, it's those small mistakes. We saw it from Eve Maxi with the accidental warden. ability as he was swiping through. Then we saw it with Nebrax, where the battle blimp popped just outside the wall, and who knows if he was they are able to make those adjustments. Would it have been a difference? You know, only time would tell. Maybe they build those bases to test it again, but either way, they're focused on this match still. They're trying to hope for defenses, but JX Tiger is looking to add more 3 stars to the board. Starting off with a queen charge. We've got Dragon Riders, we got Balloons, a Stone Slammer. We got a mix of many things here. Let's see how much value this queen can get. I'm thinking near this town hall, will we see some Rocket Loons? Maybe just snuck inside this clan castle to throw this queen off. Let's keep our eye on it.
Yeah, we'll keep our eye. He will have to be mighty fast, freezing them up, holding them off. And we've got the goblins coming out. We've got the minions.
Okay.
So we do want to poison up the minions and get them in there and freeze up those headhunters. Queen, though, is able to hang on tight here. And with what he's shaped up, the pathing should easily bypass this poison bomb.
Yeah, with the super minions now going down, the queen does secure them. The king is coming, making his way from the right side. Can't grab that archer tower with his queen, but he decides to send his royal champion in there. She should be able to help secure this air defense as the queen continues her path around towards that single target inferno. Another rage going down, but the healers are not in the rage, but their RC is going to help assist take down the enemy royal champion.
We do want to get a nice narrowed out pathing for the drag riders. Oh, I prefer to see that. But
the queen's ability was forced. He didn't freeze the single target inferno.
I think a little bit too focused on getting that king down, getting those drag riders in, but the queen carries on, and he's got one more rage to come through.
Whoa.
The one thing, though, is we'd like to see her clear up as much as possible here, even getting to that scatter shot, but at least he's down the defending AQ.
The invisibility spells for his royal champion help clear that multi-target inferno beautifully. Now the queen stays alive. The stone slammer pops, takes out the air defense, now goes for the multi-target inferno. What an attack from Chichin coming in with that queen. Doesn't have her ability, but we're sending some balloons and a hog rider from the bottom side of this base, and we've got ourselves a 3-star.
Huge swarm of dragon riders coming through as the queen beats her way through the wall to help with the assist. Time certainly not a factor. Chichin is in a beautiful position for JX Tiger. I don't think he lost one dragon rider in this.
I know, right? Incredible stuff. What a gorgeous attack. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dragon riders still alive. He came in with 4, meaning there was one inside of the battle blimp that was actually ended up being used over on the far left side of the base. So we got so much value. That queen stayed alive. The royal champion was able to help path their way through, take out that air defense, which was really important because that helped protect the queen's healers as she walked around.
Absolutely. And the queen actually being there for the back end, distracting the scattershot, is also a nice thing to consider, though I don't know that the drag riders really needed that, considering how much he had working along here.
Yeah, with that 3-star, now Tribe Gaming is hoping to come in with back-to-back triples, and they're just hoping to get defenses at this point. That's their only real chance of making a comeback, because they know that being down a percentage is almost like being down an extra star, because it's going to be so hard to make a comeback. Look at the percentage. 98.3 for JX Tiger, 88.7 for Tribe Gaming. So at this point, Tribe just needs to try to win by a star to have a chance.
They certainly do. And Evecheck is one of the OGs for Tribe Gaming, of course, being there from the start, and a long line history of competitive play, having played with Dark Looters in the past. Now he starts off with a Warden. We actually see him switching quite a bit between ground and air. Great Lalo attacker, but also very well versed in these P.E.K.K.A. Smash style attacks. And the Warden used to pick off the town hall here. It is a time investment, but there wasn't a lot along the outskirts, so he will be able to keep this moving forward quite a bit early.
Indeed, that earthquake was beautifully used, because remember, that earthquake is going to help damage the town hall so much. It won't force those builders to go back once they're help healing it, but it just takes out so much health once that warden's under raid. But out come some headhunters, super minions. Ooh, those headhunters look like they were targeting that Grand Warden. So did his ice go perfectly freeze all of that as he continues his path? now using the Warden Eternal Tome. Look at that. Even has some balloons under the Warden ability to take out the Inferno Tower.
Yeah, taking out the Inferno Tower, pushing their way along. Always nice if you could pick up some traps along the way here as well, keeping those healers nice and safe. But Pekkas are here taking the lead. Super Wizards behind. And here come the reinforcement of Hogs right out of the Siege Barracks to help work along with the King and the Royal Champion.
Yeah, now the Hogs making their way to the left. We got the King just getting picked off by that Grand Warden. This is looking pretty good for Evcheck here as the World Champions continue her path around. That is a double cannon locking onto her, but she will help secure it. Does actually have her ability. The Queen's ability is still intact, so it's going to be a matter of if the RC can stay alive. There's the ability. Down goes Tesla in the more of the Archer Tower. Now the RC makes her way to the Ground Expo with a minute left. She won't be able to survive this. The Ground Expo will be picking these Wizards off. No! It actually locks onto the Queen, but no more healers here. The Queen's gonna utilize the jump!
Wow, that Queen with the 200 IQ moves there. You often expect your Queen to be beating on a wall, but she does the right job, takes the jump. 41 seconds left to go, and they still need to get back over to the 2 o'clock side of the base. This Queen has been trained very well.
She indeed has. She's going to make her way around. The cannon's going to go down to the minions. It's coming down to time. 30 seconds left. The Wizard's going for that. The Queen's going to step her way to go for the air defense. The multi-mortar. Then the gold sword is about to... How much health does that have? The Queen doesn't have much health. He's like it. He's pumping his fist. He's going to be getting a 3-star 4. Tribe Gaming gives that thumbs up. Beautiful job. Evcheck needed a 3-star, and they did just that.
Oh, just when they needed it the most, Evcheck comes in with a beautiful triple, and he is happy. This team is fighting their way to stay in the upper bracket, but we still have a lower bracket. No one's going to go away from this match. At very least, there is some sort of safety net, but they still have a shot here today.
Yeah, they want to make it from the upper bracket, because if you get knocked down to the lower bracket, that means you have to make it to the finals and then win 2 times in a row, because the winner that's coming from the upper bracket has to lose due to being double elimination. And that is so difficult to do. There is so much on the line. And with that 3-star, Tribe Gaming has a chance. They're hoping for back-to-back defenses in these next couple attacks from JX Tiger.
Yeah, and that is what we're all waiting to see, if Tribe can do this. You always have to root, and I can't believe I'm saying this, root for the underdog and hope to see it. But to imagine that Tribe is in this position shows the power of JX Tiger. As Joan comes in with the 4th attack for the team, there is still plenty of opportunity here for Tribe.
We'll see, starting off with that Yeti to help take down the Archer Tower to set a little bit of a funnel as well. The Tesla did pop, but shouldn't be too big of a deal as one dragon does make its path over to help take that down. Early battle blimp coming in. Remember, these dragons are going to path their way into the core. Early warden ability. Will a lava hound be inside of this clan castle? It looks like it is. So if that clan castle does not go down, that lava hound could come out and be a big problem late in the raid.
Beautiful approach, taking down the Town Hall, Clone Loon's perfection, clearing out the surrounding defenses, and when those clear it out, it ideally gives a pass to the dragons to force their way into the core of the base, bypassing the poison bomb, so you get even more value. Unfortunately, looks like they're getting targeted by the Eagle here. Yeah. We want to swiftly work our way along. The King's right there, has the ability to take it down, but the Queen slightly landlocked.
The Queen is locked behind that wall there as the Ground Expo has locked onto her. She's going to force her ability pretty much. There it goes. We've got the freeze on the bottom scatter. These dragons are taking a massive amount of damage from that multi-target inferno. The RC's got her ability. One freeze left. These dragons are slowly getting picked off. That air defense is going to do work. Wait a second. Do we have a potential defense? But that RC is going to get so much value. I don't think so. I think we got ourselves a 3-star from Joan of JX Tiger just due to that Royal Champion.
Yeah, just waiting patiently. Launched off the Seeking Shield.
Oh, giant bomb. She goes down. No way. She stays alive. She's taking out the multi. She goes down. How much health does these dragons have?
We still have the Yak as well to try and come
in. The Unicorn is healing the Yak. Oh my god, the Unicorn. Okay, 50 seconds left. The dragon has like no health there. The baby dragon is gonna make its way. There's the tornado jump. Oh, the dragon goes down. Headhunter's gonna get picked off. No way. Is the Yak gonna save this? Headhunter goes down. Dragon stays alive. Air Skelly slowing these dragons down. Sinking air mine. Red air bombs. No way, the Yak.
The Yak is going to clutch this three-star.
What?
And Joan keeping JX Tiger on top of their game.
Wow, unbelievable. The Unicorn healed the Yak, which then helped finish off that final multi-target Inferno. What a way to finish off that attack from JX Tiger. Hey, sometimes it just can be a matter of luck finishing off that final building there. Indeed, it was with that multi going down. Beautiful hit. And hey, a three-star is indeed a three-star.
That is not something you see every day.
No.
The Unicorn, the Yak, and also being the clutch factor to get that job done. And of course, we would see it in this incredible World Championship matchup where everyone is putting their best foot forward. Now, Exorcist here, again, he's going to come in with a three-star. He's going to keep the dream alive for Tribe if they can hold a defense in that final attack.
Exorcist needs a triple. That, there's no question about it. And then the only chance they have is if they hold JX Tiger to a very low percentage two-star at that. But with the Queen making her way into the Town Hall, the healers are looking to be out of range of the Town Hall, so they should be protected. Drops a few more balloons, really wants to make sure he protects these healers from sinking air mines as he continues this charge in.
Yeah, so working his way along, we have those builders just slowing this down by continuously healing up the Town Hall, building it back to health. So a little bit of a time constraint, but not too much, and it's something that Exorcist knows how to handle well, considering this Drag Rider attack is one of their most common strategies. Baby Dragon along the outskirt edge, we are starting to line up just a little bit more of this pathing and funnel to push along.
Yeah, that super minion is going to reroute back to the Queen, does use the freeze spell to push it, keep it inside of the poison spell there. But here comes the Stone Slammer with the Dragon Riders moving into the Scattershot on the bottom side. The Queen is inside the Tornado Trap. She's getting spun around a little bit, but looks like she's staying alive. And now this King, he's going to loop his way to the enemy King and the Eagle Artillery to the top side.
Yeah, great funnel set up here to allow that King the easy access working along. And while that King works his way and sneaks the Royal Champion through to help pick off those outlying defenses. But look at the Cutter Cross. She's going to work right alongside now with these Drag Riders.
Yeah, that Queen takes out the enemy Queen. This is looking really strong so far. That King is still up. He's making his way around, distracting these point defenses, including the Archer Tower. Dragon Riders are coming through. The RC still has their ability. The Queen has their ability with an additional freeze in. Exorcist looks to be putting a three-star on the board. We just have under 1 minute left, but with the abilities of his heroes, it should be wrapping these defenses up. There it is for the Queen. Takes out this Builder Hut, and beautiful job. So Tribe is going to put on a 13-star performance here in this match. Now, JX Tiger, they get a two-star. They will be at 13 stars, so it's about how much percentage they get.
Yeah, they have the opportunity, but it is still a very, very big ask here, especially what we've been seeing working along for JX Tiger. Their defense not only in their favor, but they have been on top of their game today.
Yeah, indeed. JX Tiger is coming through. It's been the story of their defenses. Tribe Gaming yesterday started off the World Championship with a perfect war against the defending champions alternate attacks, and then now they get 13 stars. So that is a big difference in terms of JX Tiger's looking to put up 14 here in this war. And we talked about it. You have to be putting up 14 star performances to be taking down these teams here, Lady B.
And not always, as we saw yesterday. Sometimes it comes down to the perfect war.
Yeah.
Not going to be the case in this matchup today, but still right there on top with these big star counts. Exactly what we want to see in the World Championship Finals. Now, Mott coming in here, we do have more Drag Rider action, but he's only got three in the mix.
Yeah, with that lightning spell helping take out that single target in front of the queen is down. She's going to be making her way closer to the town hall. The queen with the unicorn taking his time, not dropping the healers just yet because you know the air defense is down here. Not too much point defenses on to the queen at all, really nothing just yet. And he's going to utilize the battle blimp, probably going to have a dragon rider with some balloons inside of there. Yep, indeed, there it is, to help take down the eagle artillery. Look at that. Here comes the healers as he pushes this queen into the town hall.
Yeah, beautiful approach on this one, queen. We want to see her, again, investing even more, not just the town hall. We have the healers. It needs to be more than that, especially when we're bringing drag riders and only three of them to the table. But we still have more coming in from the king. Sends in the Yeti from the outskirts and picks up a mini Tesla farm here.
Yeah, so we're looking at the bottom left of our screen, and it looks like all he needs to do is get a 72% two-star to win this war. Eagle Artillery's down. The queen is still up with the town hall secured. This is looking really good. And this is a Lava Hound Ice Golem. So this queen is going to be under no threat whatsoever at this point. Poison spell is being used. And he's just going to be able to try to coast his way to victory here.
Yeah, 72% two-star seems like an easy order for JX Tiger, especially with having this queen charge that is already underway with a powerful push and the king being invested with the royal champion to take out this 3 o'clock section of the base, taking down the scattershot. Because we only have three drag riders, it needs this force and narrow pathing.
It really does. With that warden on ground, he's really trying to get as much value from the king, and beautiful warden ability. The key is popping the warden ability when you have all the barbarians spawned from the king, because when you do that, you get incredible value as you push your way through with all the extra DPS from them. Plus, they provide a little bit of distraction from the other defenses. The queen stays alive, and this is looking crushed from among of JX Tiger. That queen's ability finally goes off, has the RC ability, skipping his way through, and this was a gorgeous attack. And they're going to be pushing it up to 14 stars. And that is really the performance that you're going to have to do at this competition. You're going to have to be putting up 14. You're going to have to be putting up 15 stars. But what does that mean for Tribe Gaming? Well, they are going to be going down to the lower bracket. They are not out. They still have a chance. But the road from the lower bracket is so incredibly difficult. But GG to JX Tiger. Congratulations. Knocking down Tribe Gaming. You're continuing in the upper bracket. And who are they going to be waiting to face?
Ooh, they will be waiting to face off against Queen Walkers or
Affiliate Esports.
My goodness, this is going to be absolutely legendary.
Yes.
But you know what? That Queen Walkers Affiliate Esports, you know, this is one that I think everybody has their eye on.